But we're one day closer to eternity. And listen, somebody out there tonight, and listen, let me tell you, this could be the very last church service that you ever get to be in. This could be the very last service that I could be in. But let me tell you, if I was to leave here tonight, I'd go to my heavenly home up there, because I got my mind and I got my heart set on the things above where Jesus is. And Jesus is up there tonight. And not only is he on the right hand of the Father, he's in the hearts of men, women, boys, and girls around this big world, and we need to get our minds off these old earthly things. These old earthly things are going to pass away. They're going to burn with vermin heat someday. But let me tell you, everything that we've ever done for the Lord, I'm telling you, let me tell you, I tell them all the time down Morgan Branch, listen, working for the Lord, let me tell you something, the reward is out of this world. One of these days he's going to say, come. Come on through here. Come on, my good and faithful servants. You've been faithful over a few things. I'm going to make you ruler over many. Enter to the joys of my Father. And I'll tell you what, you're talking about a church service, but we'll have one throughout eternity. Listen, we'll be able to sing songs that the angels can't sing, because we've been redeemed by that precious blood of the Lamb. Listen, Jesus is right there tonight, and he's got room in heaven for everybody if they just, listen, if they just call on his name tonight, and they just believe in him, and believe that he is the Son of God. Believe he did die for him. He went to that bar tomb, and the third day he ascended out there, and he's on the right hand tonight. He wants the Christian people around the world tonight, turn loose of the world and grab a hold of something that's going to last throughout eternity. We need to turn loose of these earthly things, because we're going to leave them behind someday.
That's right.
Anyway.
That's right.
Apostle Paul said, the things we see is eternal. Listen, is temporary. And the things that we can't see, listen, is eternal. Let me tell you something. I'm excited about that place called heaven. Let me tell you, a long time ago when I gave my heart to the Lord, listen, I didn't get saved that night because I was in love with Jesus, but I got saved that night because of the message. Listen, it convicted me, and listen, and Jesus knocked in my heart's door, and I made him my Savior that night, and I ain't never ever been the same, and I hope I get foolisher by the days for this man called Christ, because there's a lot of people out there that are not lost and undone, and they need to set their hearts on the things above where Jesus is, because Jesus is getting ready to come back and get them that belong to him. He's coming back down here. He's coming to get them that belong to him, and I believe he's talking to the Christian people. He said, if you be risen in Christ, seek the things above where Jesus is on the right hand of the Father. Get your mind off the earthly things, because these earthly things will rob you of a many of a blessing. These earthly things, listen, for too long, every service you miss church, it gets a little easier and a little easier, because these earthly things down here can keep you pretty busy. And let me tell you something. There ain't nothing down here worth. I said, there ain't nothing down here worth dying and going to that place called hell for. There ain't nothing worth dying and going to that place for. And Jesus is a remedy tonight. He came down here to die that you and I wouldn't have to. He came down here to give me and you life and give it to us more abundantly. You don't have to wait till you get to heaven to enjoy salvation. We need to enjoy it down here. We need to let people know that he's the living God tonight, and he ain't dead, but he's up there in heaven tonight making intercession for you and I. Every time me and you fail, listen, when we kneel down and ask Jesus to go to the Father, he goes to the Father on our behalf and says, he ain't much down there, but he believes in me, and he confessed his sin, and he said, if you confess his sin, he said, I'm just and right to forgive and cleanse you of all unrighteousness. He didn't say some, he didn't say many, he didn't say few, but he said, I'll forgive all your sin. And you know what? We need to set our hearts on the things above. I mean, listen, when the Bible talks about them streets of gold, when the Bible talks about them pearly gates, when the Bible talks about Jesus being the light of that city, when the Bible talks about that good stuff, I tell you, it runs cold chills on me, thinking someday he's going to call me out. Someday he's going to say, enter to the joys of my Father. And listen, it ain't going to be as long as it has been, because because every day that I live, I'm getting a day older. Every day that we live down here, these old earthly things rob us, and we need to quit letting the earthly thing rob us, and we need to start praising God more. We need to start lifting Jesus up, and if we'll lift Jesus up, he said he'll draw all men to you, because somebody's going to plant a seed, somebody's going to come behind you and water it, but God will give the increase. And let me tell you something, in the last 5 weeks down at Morgan Branch, we've seen 5 souls come and give their heart to the Lord. That's just the beginning. We're going to work harder than we ever have. We're going to fast. We're going to pray. We're going to get out, knock on doors. We're going to get out there and go to work for this man called Christ, because these earthly things won't be worth a dime.
That's right.
When you stand before the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
These earthly things won't be worth a dime. I ain't never seen no earthly things hooked to a hearse, Brother Jonathan.
Yeah, right.
I ain't never seen no U-Haul behind a hearse as it's going to the graveyard. There ain't no U-Haul behind it. And the stuff that we put in the way down here, we need to get it out of the way. And we need to just praise this man for what he did for us. We need to lift him up, because he died for you and I. He died that me and you don't have to go to that awful place of torment. God didn't create hell for mankind, but he created it for the devil and the fallen angels. But there'll be people tonight. There'll be people to not go to that awful place, because they thought more of the things of this earth than they do the Son of God.
Yeah.